Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sam, and in this video we will see ultrasound soft markers for Down syndrome. Soft markers are features that may indicate aneuploidies in a fetus. We will compare these soft markers with a normal fetus. This is a normal image of a fetus in the first trimester. It shows us a normal nuchal thickness. The normal nuchal thickness in first trimester is less than 3 millimeters approximately. And over here we have a fetus with increased nuchal thickness. It will be greater than 3 millimeters in the first trimester. Increased nuchal thickness is a soft marker for Down syndrome. In this image, we see a normal nasal bone. Right here, this hyperechoic bone. And in this image, we have an absent nasal bone. We do not see a hyperechoic bone. This is another soft marker for Down syndrome. Echogenic intracardiac focus is a hyperechoic structure seen within the fetal heart. It looks like a hyperechoic dot. In the normal image, no such hyperechoic structure is seen within the heart. This can be seen in a fetus with Down syndrome. In this image, we see two echogenic structures. This increases the chance of having Down syndrome. Here is an image of the fetal brain showing normal lateral ventricles. Their normal measurement is usually less than 10 millimeters. Ventriculomegaly is the dilatation of ventricles. In a fetus with Down syndrome, it may have mild ventriculomegaly. The measurement of the lateral ventricles will be more than 10 millimeters. The normal nuchal thickness in the second trimester must be less than 6 millimeters. It can be measured in the transverse view of the fetal brain at the level of the cerebellum. And here is an image of an increased nuchal thickness. We can see an increased measurement. It may be seen in a fetus with Down syndrome. This is a coronal image of the fetal bowel. We do not see any hyperechoic region here. Whereas in this image, we see echogenic bowel. The bowel are hyperechoic. This may also be seen in a fetus with Down syndrome. This is a normal small bowel image in a transverse view. And this is an image of echogenic bowel. We see a large hyperechoic area. A short femur is diagnosed when the femoral length is short for gestational age. It is associated with many congenital anomalies. It can be seen in a fetus with Down syndrome. A short humerus is also associated with Down syndrome. The humeral length is short for gestational age. It is often seen in a fetus with Down syndrome. This is a transverse view showing normal fetal kidneys. We can see the renal pelvis in each kidney. The anechoic area is the renal pelvis. And over here we have dilated renal pelvis. The AP diameter is more than 4 millimeters till 28 weeks and more than 7 millimeters after 28 weeks. This may also be associated with Down syndrome. A fetus with Down syndrome can have an abnormal spectral Doppler waveform of the ductus venosus. Here is a normal spectral Doppler waveform of ductus venosus. It has a triphasic pattern. The wave with the highest peak is the S wave, and it occurs at ventricular systole. The D wave is the second highest peak, and it represents early diastole. And the lowest point is the A wave, and it represents atrial contraction. In an abnormal waveform, we will find flow reversal at A wave. The A wave is seen below the baseline. A ventricular septal defect is a discontinuity in the interventricular septum. This is the defect. It is also a soft marker for Down syndrome. A normal fetal stomach is seen as a round anechoic structure in the abdomen in a transverse view. A birth defect known as esophageal atresia is also sometimes associated with Down syndrome. The esophagus does not develop properly, and this leads to non-visualization of stomach because no fluid reaches the stomach and the stomach remains invisible persistently. A duodenal atresia can lead to a dilated stomach and duodenum, giving a double bubble appearance. In some cases, it is associated with Down syndrome. Ultimately, Down syndrome is diagnosed with invasive tests such as chorionic villus sampling and amniocentesis. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and stay tuned for more imaging videos.